Hi guys, we're going to show you an experiment to demonstrate the first law of thermodynamics. The material that you need for this experiment are beaker, double-sided tape, and syringe. First, increase the air volume inside of the syringe to 10 ml. Right after that, tape the syringe to make sure that there is no air leaking out. And then heat 400 ml of water in a beaker from room temperature up to 85 degrees Celsius. Once the water temperature reaches 85 degrees Celsius, immerse the syringe that was prepared before into the water. And once the syringe is fully immersed, you should be able to see the movement of the piston showing the gas expansion. And now you could see that it actually moved from 10 ml to 20 ml. From this experiment, we could observe that as the syringe is being heated up, the volume increases from 10 ml to 20 ml. This could be easily explained by the ideal gas law, PV is equal to nRT. To keep the pressure constant, as the temperature increases, the volume has to increase as well. But does it satisfy the first law of thermodynamics?
Well, by the first law of thermodynamics, we know that energy has to be conserved. We also know that this change in internal energy is equivalent to the sum of heat plus by work done. In our experiment, as we heat up the system, in our case is the gas molecules inside of the syringe, we know that the internal energy has to increase, which means it has to have a positive change in internal energy. It also means that the kinetic energy of the molecule inside of the syringe increases, of the gas molecules. This will result in a higher collision rate between the gas molecule and the wall of the syringe, but more importantly, a higher collision rate with the wall of the piston, pushing it up from 10 ml to 20 ml. Now, from all this, we know that delta U is actually equal to Q minus W, a negative sign being work done by the system to the surrounding. And we know that all this thing that we've done in this experiment actually satisfy the first law of thermodynamics.